welcome. I am Zeinder, and this is episode 20 of my Minecraft Let's Play. I've, since done a few more edits to the texture pack, mostly just nether brick. Yep, that's nether brick now. And that's netherrack. So, that makes the, nether look a little more sinister, in theory. We're gonna have a walk in there, just so you can get a better picture, because while that shows it off, it's not perfect. This does make soul sand stand out pretty extremely. Well, actually, it's not that bad. But I didn't like the pinkish kind of texture that was in the netherrack. It made it look kind of funny. And it also, I couldn't see very well in the nether. Like, it all just looked like one giant blob. And now it's actually distinguishable. I can see the corners apart and whatnot. And I rather like how it turned out, but you guys have to give me your thoughts on that. And man, do nether fortresses fucking stand out. That is nuts. But, that's enough of that. I am going to put a bunch of shovels. Walked the wrong way out of the portal, apparently. And, I want to make a boat dock. Plain and simple. It's going to be a bit of a building episode. And I kind of feel like the black wool seems a little unsaturated. For some reason, a little brownish looking. But we're not going to worry about that at the very moment. If I decide to do something with that, we'll figure that out later. In the meantime, I swear I know what I'm doing. Or maybe not. Maybe not. I haven't quite decided on that yet. I did more or less, I couldn't really think of a whole lot of what I wanted to do for this episode. The same problem I had last episode, I couldn't really think of anything. But that's not the reason why this episode was delayed in comparison to the last one. I actually had company and thought about recording with them here, but then I just decided against it. But I'm going to figure out where I want this boat dock to be, and it's probably not going to link up too well, and the house is probably going to be extended more at some point, which is just going to be more nether brick farming. But I think right here, down in this area, looks like a good place for the boat dock. And like I said before, I want to build it inside of the hill, but that's why we needed a lot of shovels. But, this nice little bucket of water here that'll help me resolve any of these discrepancies with the water not deciding to form itself. I can eventually fix it myself. But it's gonna go back. There's gonna be, I was originally wanting to dig into like a cave, and if that's the plan, I'm gonna have to dig pretty far back on this hill, probably to about here. I think I'm going to actually just dig out a bit of an outline right now. And, as usual, going to be working through the night at this. So, yeah. Chance of me getting killed? High probability. But, I haven't really gotten any feedback on the adventure map. Like, whether people want me to do more adventure maps. I do have that one, in my personal opinion, was a little bit boring to play, but it was okay. It had an okay story, at least. The next one I'm planning to do is one of Vex's maps. And in case you don't know what his maps are about, they are called Super Hostile. Or Hostile, or I don't know, depending on how you want to pronounce it. Basically, there will be a lot of death, most likely. I won't be playing it by myself. It'll be another multiplayer one. After the last adventure map I put up, someone I talked to contacted me saying that he wanted to be involved in it. So, there's probably going to be three of us. And it's probably going to be, this last one I recorded it in one day. Super Hostile maps aren't designed to be done in one day, to my knowledge. So, it's going to take a little while, but that's fine. It's another complete set of, another complete set of videos to be uploaded. So, and they're going to, you know, not be just this random nonsense that I'm doing in my single player here, but they're going to be more along the lines of more interesting things in comparison. And you know, it would actually be kind of handy if a creeper dropped down right now and blew out some of this wall. Although, they only attack you when you don't want them to. Trying to think of more things to say. I'm actually need, like, some general plans in general. Like, I enjoy caving, but I've had issues finding caves. And one of the easiest way to find caves is to, like, build a tunnel or something. But I don't really have anywhere to tunnel to, and I'm actually thinking about, putting in 1.2, and then, going and looking for a... Sorry about that, my mind just kind of blanked out as I was saying that. Going and looking for a jungle biome, and taming some cats and whatnot, and just playing in it like it's normal, and then when it comes out, full release, hopefully it has some other stuff other than what's in it right now, and if it doesn't, well then, I actually consider it fine if it just has that, because cats, plain and simple, I like cats. So I'm sure you noticed by the fact that I put a picture of a cat into my paintings file. Yes, I'm aware I just finished digging this out, but then I realized I wanted something to stand on while doing this. Whoops. Okay, I think it's just screwing with me. And it formed itself, That's good. That's very good. Oops. Now, when I take out this middle spot here, the whole thing should just form itself again. Does it need to be so wide? No. Did I do it anyway? Yeah. I did. Now, actually, I think I'm going to... I should still match up. You know, I really don't really have a way out of here too much, but, it's not a big deal. Now, I'm going to have... I want to have another little spot where you come in, park the boats. Gonna have this right about here. And yes, I should have thought about this beforehand when I was digging out, but I'm just kind of improvising as I go, so don't hold it against me. I do know that, like, some of the stuff I'm leaving in right now, it's not going to be final. It's just there as a marker, basically. I don't know if you get to see, not so much get to see, but quite understand what my final design is supposed to be. I should have just left those there, but there's going to be soul sand under there and against all these edges here, because to my knowledge, if a boat hits soul sand, it does not break. Which is a kind of handy feature of soul sand. I'm going to have boat storage over here, even though, as long as I'm fairly careful, I shouldn't really need too many more boats, but, careful, well, if I was being careful, I wouldn't have died so many times in previous episodes, so, yeah. That sounded like a very unhappy Enderman. Luckily, I'm at least partly safe down here, other than the fact that I haven't placed any torches whatsoever. This one there, one there. I don't know why, but for some reason the lighting looks a little more vibrant. I don't know if that's quite the word I was going for, but I'm going to stick with it. Now, I think this is going to be the final backward row. It's going to look pretty cool when it's done. The entire outside up to right about there, so that's actually probably going to go outside and put another layer of dirt on that. It's going to be wood, and these are going to be stairs if you haven't figured that out yet. I'm just going to end up, it's going to go right up to the surface, and I'm probably going to add to my house at some point. Gonna be a safe passage over to this then. I have a general idea of a lot of things I want to do, but the actual creativity, not one of my strong points. That's why I've actually considered moving on to like a multiplayer Let's Play where somebody can consistently do the videos with me, just because they can help give me ideas, but I can do the more practical things. And whoa! Whoa, skeleton apocalypse. Well, probably not apocalypse. I think I want to pull this back one more, just so that way I don't clank my head on the way down. Whoa. Ow, you hit me. Bastard. Do have, you know, I'm pretty sure I've said this, but I have a general idea of what I plan to do. General and actual, though, big difference there. I don't exactly want to fall off of that. Where? Oh. See, I actually want to level this down. I've been meaning to do some leveling at least a little bit outside my house, because I don't like that one window being at exactly ground level. Of course, though, to be honest, I don't like that whole hill so much. But we'll see what I do with that in the future. I haven't fully decided on whether or not I want to completely try and clear it out, or what I want to do. I do know that that looks a little better. Whoops. Not where I meant to put that. Once the grass grows, that should all be fine. Hey, 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 hey. This is gonna be hideous. I know people aren't gonna like it. But I'm going to connect to the house right there. Need a whole walkway over. I'm probably gonna need to harvest some more trees. Oh, I hate breaking glass. Now, that's eventually going to be, like, a tunnel. So I'm probably going to put pressure plates on both sides. But as it currently stands, I'm not even going to place a pressure plate. And I am going to need to remove that dirt block at some point. But, I'm going to go down. Chop out some trees. I should harvest that. Better yet, I should add to that. You guys don't really need to see this, so I'm gonna stop the video and I'll get back to you right after I'm done chopping out the trees. So, see you. Okay, we're back. Haven't done too much. Grabbed some of the wood out of my chest, grabbed my nether bricks just in case. Went and whacked the reeds. I actually cleared the wheat farm and deposited that and dropped a bunch of stuff out of my inventory I didn't really need. We're gonna go back out here. And I don't quite know why I'm doing this with wood at the moment, because there's a good chance... Whatever. Those will probably stay there. These won't. But I'm going to be expanding the house in this direction at some point. I suppose I just wanted to look decent. I didn't want to be wood, but I didn't want to put nether brick here just because... Well, I have no idea. Be honest. You know, Okay, never mind. I was gonna raise it to a 3-high roof, but I decided not to in the process of doing it. I may actually at some point just extend the house the whole way back, so this is actually in the back of the house, essentially. It would actually line up quite well, to be honest. But, that's a different thing for a different time, and I don't talk about lining up. Lining up the torch right in my way. I probably should have. Actually, do I have one? Oh, good. I do have a workbench on me. This is gonna be kind of weird, going from a 3-wide path to a 2-wide path. But, well. Maybe I could go grab some more of my wood if I want to do the plan that I had in mind. Because I need fences. Whoa. I need light. Oh. Actually, I did say I wanted to do all of this in pretty much wood, so I guess I am going to need to go grab pretty much all of my wood, so. I also need a floor. So I should probably grab my wool, too. Whoops. Yeah, like I said, I cleared out my wheat farm. And I've actually had a good number of wood beforehand that I didn't tell you about, kind of. I'm gonna bring it just in a wood form at the moment. Right, wool. I've been shearing the sheep quite often, if you can't tell by my large numbers of wool. So I'm game to expand this floor very easily. And there goes the door. This is mostly contained anyhow, fairly safe other than the water area, but we won't worry about this very second. What we are going to do is cut this out and line it properly the whole way over. As for this part, I need to figure out where it would link up with the house. I'm just gonna do just the middle line at the moment. You know, the time I spent switching to the shears there completely surpasses the amount of time it would have taken me to just break it by hand. Which means, yes, I'm absolutely terrible. Was the least efficient way of handling that. But, a little bit too late for that. And I actually, from the looks of it, if I did expand my house, I would not have anywhere near as much wool as I would need. Apparently, I would need a ton of nether brick, too, so. If I keep building out a nether brick, that entire fortress is just gonna be destroyed. There's gonna be nothing left. Just, at some point, there's gonna be a floating blaze spawner. While that would look very amusing, and I probably should trap it at some point, the fact that magma slimes drop the magma cream now, I'm not too worried. Although I think you need blaze powder to make glistering melons, which is the instant health. Which I haven't done any alchemy yet, to be honest. And to be honest, I need to stop saying to be honest. And I probably shouldn't have done that. As you can tell, I'm still working on figuring out how I want to design this while I'm building it. It's not where I wanted those, and it's going to end up being a waste of wood. But, oh well. You know, with that stack of 64 wood, I might be able to complete this. Like, not wood planks, but I mean the actual wood that I have. I might be able to complete this. It's unlikely, but it's entirely possible. Yes, those torches are now disappearing again. You know, I'm not putting it in steps anytime soon, so at least don't think I am. Whoa! So much for me thinking it was gonna be safe down here. Looks like I'm gonna need to put that door back, and fairly soon. But, boring building episode, but of course, so I shouldn't, I guess it's not really up to me to determine what's boring. It's up to you guys. Whatever you like to see is what's not boring. Boring is decided by the viewers. And considering I have, like, 5 regular viewers at best, I guess there's a very small opinion. But, this shouldn't turn out looking too bad, I hope. And am I probably going to use the boat? Knowing me, not really. I'll probably explore on boats first to see if I can't find the jungle biome when I go to 1.2, which, like I said, I'll probably do soon. It'll be something fairly interesting to do, and I know a lot of people are doing jungle-related stuff already, even though it's not technically released. But it's a new patch. It's new for me. It's new for most people, unless you've been playing in 1.2 since it came out. Then it's not really new to you, but, I mean, it's new to me, and tall trees, probably get to watch me fall out of some. Everybody seems to think you need to build a treehouse if you're playing in the jungle. I just don't grasp that concept. Maybe I don't like the idea of a house at a spot where I can easily fall down and kill myself if I make one wrong move. But that's just me. Right. I swear I know what I'm doing. Or pretending to know what I'm doing. I swear I'm telling you that I know what I'm doing when I actually don't. If I'm gonna say something, might as well make it the truth. Revoke my lies and substitute them with the actual truth. Trying to remember the spacing, which you'd think would be fairly obvious, but I seem to be having issues with things being obvious at the moment. They're not obviously obvious enough. I don't know why I made so much an effort to get one piece of dirt, but I'm gonna need soul sand, because I don't think I brought too much back. Actually, now that I remember, I think the one episode I actually dug, you know, I don't even remember. I'm gonna have to go look. I said I was gonna make this whole line. Well, this doesn't need to be soul sand. Make it easier to get off on the edges. I'm gonna burn through a lot of wood doing this, but it's probably worth it. Who knows? Maybe one day my house will actually look cool. But at the current moment, it kind of looks like crap. I mean, it only even looks good because I'm using a texture pack, whoops, designed to make it look better. But, once again, I guess that's something best left to the viewers, not me. I like it with my texture pack. How it looks without the texture pack, well, I'll leave that up to you guys to figure out and have your opinions on. Opinions are probably more important than my own, but, who knows? Fences. Now, do some of this. If I put it down one more, I'm pretty sure I can't get out, but, it doesn't matter. I think it actually looks pretty good like that. I kind of think that I want them to go the whole way down on the sides, but then I'd probably have to extend this whole thing out, and it'd also kind of make soul sand on the sides irrelevant. So, soul sand on the sides, scrapped. That was a very quickly scrapped idea, wouldn't you say? Where am I? Okay. See, I think that looks a lot better. And I thought about doing something with redstone, but it's a boat dock. I mean, yeah, there's plenty I could do with redstone. I could make a gate. I don't know how well it would play with water. Like, it wouldn't be a full-on gate. Whoops. Because that wouldn't work too well. There's a lot involved in trying to set up things in ways like that. But it would be like a little gate there because the mobs wouldn't be able to get past it. Which wouldn't really work because I'd have no way to hand... Well, I could put a button on the outside or something. See, this is what it's about. Determining what I can do with redstone in ways that it was probably never really designed. Although it was probably designed at the same time. But, coal's bothering me. I have to get it. For some reason, right about now, I feel like I want a really big excuse to play with redstone. But I don't even really need an excuse to play with redstone. There's no reason why I just shouldn't use it, but for some reason, I find some of the things like the, like, you know, watering out the wheat farm for quick harvesting and whatnot, I just don't know if I really feel it too video-worthy, but then again, hey, probably is, and I'm just being stingy. But, I need to do something about that. I don't want to just do it with dirt, even though that would be the logical decision. But I'm not entirely sure what I'd put down there. I'm thinking maybe sand, actually. Of course, so I'd have to go get sand. Because I don't have any. But, just talking mindlessly. Although, I gotta say, single player can be kind of boring. Because, personally, I find games a lot more interesting with somebody to talk to. And I'm not really doing that. Because it's single player. You're probably wondering why I'm screwing this up so much. Can I tell you right now? Don't know. This should get me the whole way up. I'm gonna leave that grass to let decide what I want to do with that. Do need to place torches. Place one there, and one there. Ooh, it appears I forgot the outer torches. See, if I wanted to actually put a gate here and do it properly and have it switchable from the outside, I need to do an XOR gate. And it's one of the more complicated ones that I can never seem to remember, and I always have to look it up. I don't know why. You think you like redstone so much, why can't you remember these things? I don't know. For some reason, I just have issues with it at times, but... But I can't jump over a fence. Yet I just tried. Over here, and... Ah, soul sand. Whoops. I don't need all of this. And... I'm probably going to complete this boat dock, finish the episode. However, I did... Because, well, like I said earlier, I had company, so I was planning on making this a double episode. Not double long, but I'm going to make two episodes. That way, you know, people can watch it more or less at their own rate, and they don't feel like they have to stop halfway through a video because it's twice as long. Instead, I'm just going to make two episodes. And I don't need to be carrying most of this stuff with me. I'm actually going to keep the dirt on me at the moment, though. My cobblestone chest is actually getting quite full for not actively mining. But, yep. Ooh. See, this is the only problem I have with this texture pack, is because what I did the nether brick, I'm having an issue actually telling nether brick from wool. Which is actually kind of sad. I just realized I have more dirt on me. Suppose I could have left all this stuff in my inventory and not needed to worry about it. Saved from time by not doing all this stuff on camera, but... Hey, I'm sure there's some things you're going, well, where did you put that? Or where did you put that? And now you're gonna see where I put it. Looks to be everything. I still have my nether brick on me. I'm probably gonna... keep this here for the moment, and then see how far I can extend in this direction. I'm probably going to keep that wall there in general, because what fun's a house if it's just one big box? Why not have some separators? Maybe I'll double thick it and put a piston door there. Now, I think if I ran into that full speed with a boat, it wouldn't break. Why don't we just try this? Oops. I accidentally placed the boat on the soul sand. See, one of the reasons, because whenever you're in soul sand, it more or less counts as a half block for one. Whoa. Turn boat. But, charge this thing at breaking speeds, and... Well, I was wrong. See, now I want to try half slabs. I was wrong with one thing. Why not see if I'm wrong with others? Or just leave it there. For good measure, I suppose. It actually doesn't look too bad. Oh, that's exactly what I was worried about. Cracking my head on the way down. Now I gotta move this all back. Just because I'm sick of smacking my head when walking on the stairs. Common Minecraft problem that I have. Figured it was gonna happen? Wasn't all that wrong. Make some extra. You know, I should make enough. That should be enough. No, I'm not replacing my shovel at the moment, so I'm sure you noticed. And most of the extra planks were because I want to keep the walls fairly uniform, and because of how the stairs work... Oh look, I didn't put a shovel on. Because of how the stairs work, I have to replace the blocks next to them too, which is... kind of lame. But, well, it's not really lame, it makes sense. I'm just making stuff up now. I'm not even properly... paying attention to what I'm saying. Just doing what I'm doing. I guarantee you I'm already over 30 minutes. But, so close to finishing that I might as well. If it ends up being like a billion, trillion, gazillion minutes long, I'll apologize, but I still will upload the second episode, the one that was technically for yesterday. Which I apologize on not putting that up again. I didn't make one. That's why there wasn't one. I didn't put up on the adventure map because I could have didn't really get a chance to convert it because anytime I was sleeping, the computer was being used at the time, and you can't really use the computer when you're converting. But that's good for now. Going to probably see what I can do about expanding the house. It's probably not going to be that high again. I'm probably going to drop it down to just standard 3 high. And I don't want to make the piston door out of glass, because then you can see the pistons. Plus, I don't really have any glass. But, like, I wanted to make it see-through, but you either... Well, actually, I take this back. Once again, no slimes! Completely and totally forgot to think about that. No slimes. But, I'm gonna call this the end of episode 20. So I will see you again in episode 21.